GTN Podcast The Great Master Episode 25 Hello everyone. You are listening to GTM Podcast on the Great Master Series, Learning the Historical Background and Biography of the Middle Way Meditation through Our Great Master Story. From the previous episode, we learn about the final moment of our great master on his remaining years, that he told something to his best disciple. What did he tell her? Let's find that out in this episode. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share on our channel, Great Teaching Monk, available on Spotify, YouTube, and Apple Podcast. If you have not listened to the previous episode just yet, please go back and listen to them first for more understanding and connect to the story. Now let us begin. A New Hope. As if in response to Luang Pu's prophecy, a new generation of students interested in meditation start to come to Wat Pak Nam to learn meditation from Luang Pu's top disciple, Chan Khon Nok Yung, at her humble kuti. For your information, kuti is like a little home or a little hut to stay. By then, Chan's reputation as a highly accomplished meditator was known throughout the community. Her students call her Khun Yai, a Thai word for grandmother or grandma, as a way of respect for her advancing age. Chan's meditation teaching was so popular that soon the group outgrew the space at her kuti. She subsequently built a larger facility within the compound of Wat Pak Nam and moved her meditation class there. Before long, the new facility was also outgrown. Among Chan's students were two promising young men, Chayabun Suttipon and Pradet Pongsawat, both of whom were students from Kasetsart University. After Chayabun graduated from the university in 1969, he became ordained as a Buddhist monk at Wat Pak Nam and was given the monastic name Dhammachayo Bhikkhu. After Chayabun's ordination, Chan felt the time was right for her and the team to build a Buddhist temple where true monks could be developed and the Dhammakaya knowledge could be propagated to benefit the public at large. This was indeed a grand vision. To fulfill this vision, a great deal of financial resources would be needed. Unfortunately, all that Chan has was her own savings of mere 3,000 baht, approximately about $160 in 1970. But Chan was a perpetual optimist who was driven by merit and merit power. She strongly believed that the virtue of good deeds performed by her and her team members would attract sufficient celestial treasures to make this mission possible. Chan and her team envisioned that their future temple would be built on a sizable piece of land not too far from Bangkok, with a river or creek flowing through it. The team set out to look for such a land. They found a tract of land in Pathum Thani, a paddy field 10 miles from Bangkok or Don Mueang International Airport. The land was owned by Lady Prayat, an aristocratic lady of advancing age. The team was not certain that Lady Prayat would be willing to sell part of the land she owned, but proceed to arrange for a meeting with her anyhow. The day that Chan's team met with Lady Prayat also happened to coincide with Lady Prayat's birthday. It was a lucky day for Chan and her team. Not only was Lady Prayat willing to part with the land, but she was, in fact, willing to donate the entire 78.4 acres of her land to the future temple. this was nothing short of a miracle. The temple was formally established in Maka Pucha Day, February 20, 1970. It was originally called Buddhajak Meditation Center and was later changed to Wat Pradhammakaya or the Dhammakaya Temple. The main chapel was completed in 1982. The property was later expanded to 1,000 acres in 1985. The Mahadhammakaya Sthetiya, a monumental dome-shaped Buddhist shrine, where there are 300,000 Buddha image enshrined on the exterior and 700,000 Buddha's image enshrined inside, was completed in the year 2000. The grand opening ceremony of the Sthetiya took place in Saturday, April 22, 2000. Chan Konok Yung was 91 years old when the Sthetiya was completed. She lived to see that big day. The Mahadhammakaya Sthetiya is indeed a gift to mankind. The compounds surrounding the Sthetiya are now the gathering ground for Buddhists around the world. Over 1 million Buddhists gather at Sthetiya during important Buddhist events. Chayabun Suttipon and Padet Pongsawat, who ordained subsequently, are the current abbot and vice abbot of Wat Pradhammakaya respectively. They were the driving force behind many of Chan's success. Wat Pradhammakaya, Chan's brainchild, is now one of the largest Buddhist temples in the world, with over 160 branches in 33 countries and growing. The success of Wat Pradhammakaya is a tribute to the living legacy of the great master, Luang Pu Wat Pak Nam. Even though the light that Luang Pu Wat Pak Nam had shone forth to the world is now extinguished, the flame of his teachings burns on. To this day, the heritage of the Dhammakaya knowledge continues to follow in all walks of society. Millions of people throughout the world now practice the Dhammakaya meditation tradition taught by Luang Pu Wat Pak Nam. Luang Pu's teachings have helped people discover that true peace and happiness can indeed be found within one's own self. That's everyone. This is the legacy of our great master that still exists until now. In the next episode, we will go over the teachings of what he had taught to his monks, novices, and nuns. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share on our channel, Great Teaching Monk, available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and YouTube. See you again next time.